Personal story segment tonight. Congressman Ron Paul recently told Megyn Kelly he's being ignored by the media. Since Ms. Kelly is part of the media, that was a pretty interesting statement. When we heard it, though, we immediately invited Ron Paul on the factor. We don't want anybody to be ignored. So far, he has not accepted our very kind invitation. Gallup released a poll today that's very good news for Governor Rick Perry. He leads the Republican field with 29% among those Americans likely to vote Republican. Mitt Romney, second, 17. Mr. Paul, third, 13. Michele Bachmann, who has lost some steam, she is now at 10%. You're now to analyze a purveyor of DickMorris.com, Mr. Moore. All right. Ron Paul, he's whining to Megan, ignore me, and then we invite him on, he doesn't show up.
Well, he won't face you because he doesn't want to face questioning.
He wants to give a speech, right?
He's fine when he gives a speech.
Right.
But then you probe him and you say, are you saying that Iran will not develop the bomb and that if they do, they're not going to use it against Israel? And if they do, it's okay with you? Then you say the gold standard. Are you literally saying that the United States of America's economy should only be allowed to grow as much as the gold can be extracted from the earth? And if there's no gold discovered, our economy has to stay small? You ask him about drug lords. Are you seriously saying that we should not be fighting drugs in the United States but should legalize it all?
No, he would say yes to the legalization.
He would say yes to all three of those.
No, I don't think he would say yes on the gold standard because that's impossible. So if he did that, then...
No, he's for the gold standard.
But it's not as clear-cut as that. He just wants it to back up the currency.
More currency unless more gold is mined. And ultimately, it means your whole economic expansion is hostage to how much a South African gold mine produces.
All right.
That's why when went off...
From the very beginning, and we'd had Ron Paul on this program, I have said to Mr. Paul's face that some of his positions are insane. That you can't be an isolated nation the way he wants to be, that bad guys will come and get us unless we get them first.
Right.
We all know this, except Ron Paul doesn't. But there is a strain of people there who love him, and that's what shows up in the 13 or 14% that he gets.
Those people that love him better love Obama, because if he ever gets the nomination, they can have him
would
for
win.
Four more years.
Right. Against all but Perry, I believe that Mitt Romney is much... See, this poll is a little deceiving on the Romney front because Romney's strength is not with the traditional Republican Party.
Right.
It's with independent Americans.
Right. You have to look in any of these polls to see how many independents they're putting in the sample. If it's just Republicans, it's one result. If they're putting in independents, it's another.
Right, right. And that people have to understand when you see a poll, you got to be very skeptical about the poll because certain constituencies, conservative Republicans are not big Mitt Romney supporters.
Right.
But once you get over into the independent ranks,
right.
And that is a very, very big constituency now.
And remember,
then he does much better.
With no Democratic primary, most of these states permit independents to vote in either.
Yes.
So nobody's going to be absorbed into the Democratic primary.
No,
they're all
going to
come into the Republican primary.
So those are the polls you have to
and
that's our job here to define it for.
Romney
go ahead, wrap it up.
Defeats Obama by 10 points in Florida in the most recent poll, the Magellan poll. And that is just an astonishing, astonishing lead. I think it's fair to say right now that Romney or Perry would defeat Obama. Bachmann would have a tougher time, but could. And you don't know about Christie.
So you're giving me Herman Cain, then? You're giving me Herman Cain. Sorry. Are you giving me that?
No, right now, Herman Cain would not defend
Obama. Herman's and we got like some, Herman Cain. This isn't a slam at these men.
He's a good guy, but you know what he has to do? He has to learn to take his charisma from the stump and bring it into a debate.
From DSK to OMG. So earlier this month, Republican presidential candidate Ron Paul came in second to Michele Bachmann at the Iowa straw poll. A mere couple of million votes behind her. No, actually 100. Then this past weekend, in one of his patented money bombs, Paul supporters raised over $1.8 million for his campaign. And now a new Gallup poll, a poll of people on horses, I assume, shows that among registered voters, Paul trails President Obama by only 2 percentage points, 47 to 45. The same poll shows Obama leading Michele Bachmann by 4 points, dead even with Rick Perry and trailing Mitt Romney, 48 to 46. So what does this all mean? Well, according to Gallup, only 82% of Republicans say they'll vote for Paul, as opposed to 86 for Bachmann, and the low 90s for Perry and Romney. But independents go for Paul, Perry, and Romney over Obama, Bachmann not so much. So what does it all mean? Yeah, I still don't know. Maybe Formula One cats can make sense of it. Adorable yet unhelpful, as always, Formula One cats. Bill, I go to you with you first. With all this good news about Ron Paul, why do you continue to ignore him in your coverage?
Ron who? And that's the way it's going to go, Ron Paul party. Stop emailing me.
I want to go to you, Matt. Here's the interesting or sad irony on this. It took decades for the nation to catch up to Ron Paul's principles. He's a libertarian, and we're seeing more and more libertarians, more and more dissatisfied independents who are moving away from the duopoly, which I stole from Nick Gillespie, the duopoly of Democrats and Republicans. The problem is now by the time that we have America has caught up, he's too cranky.
He's too old and cranky. He really is. I mean, he gets asked a question, you know, in these debates, and he's just pissed off. He's mad at everybody. He doesn't smile. He doesn't have the look. But the fact that the independents are really sticking up for Paul, that tells me he has got a bit of a chance because that's a swing vote. Right.
I don't think he has a real shot of being the next president or the GOP candidate, but, you know, he says some interesting things and, you know, he's keeping it interesting during
polls meaningless, too far out. It's like picking a baby's name on your first date with somebody. Secondly, of course all these challenges look good to people. It's like, you know, when you're a kid growing up and your friend's parents look really cool. You know, Bachmann's the hot, sexy mom and Romney's the cool dad and Ron Paul's the creepy uncle that'll buy you porn. So it all works out.
Matt, you said the fact that there's some support for Paul among independents makes you think he has somewhat of a chance. For the record, I disagree. He has zero chance.
Off the record?
Off the record, I think you're completely wrong.
He's got as good a chance as anybody else right now. I really do.
He can actually win. No, he really can't.
He's for legalizing drugs, which a lot of people want to do. Mm-hmm. I mean, he stands up for a lot of things that I think liberals, he gets both sides into this.
He's polling at like single digits among Republicans' primary voters.
But it gets the middle vote, and he can actually pull some from the left.
Not in the Republican primary, he can't.